Hello, welcome back to my next video on Vedic Astrology. This is part of the series Sun in various houses. Earlier on I had done the Sun in the first house, which is like this, where the Sun you'll see it along with the ascendant. And then the next video was Sun in the second house. And this time I'm going to do the effects of the Sun in the third house. The first house is always the ascendant, usually marked with some special line. Maybe you find an oblique line like this. Otherwise, it's usually mentioned as AC, or in India, you would find this referred as Lagna, L-A-G-N-A. And if the ascendant is here, and if the sun is here, this is the third house. Another way of having the same is, you would have the ascendant in Taurus or Rishabha Lagna, and then the sun in Karkataka. So you may have the sun in the third house, but still there are 12 possibilities, because each time the sun is in a different place, and that's because the ascendant is also shifted based on the time of birth. So the effect of the sun in the third will not give uniform results. Each time you will have to give importance to where the sun is. For example, if the sun is here, the sun is very happy to be here because it is his own sign. Or if the sun is here, it is exalted. So you might have a situation like this. This is very good. And another way of looking at it is, if the ascendant is here and then the sun is here, this is the third house. But here you know that the sun is nicha or debilitated in this particular sign. So I'll be referring to Bhrigu Sutra. The author is Sage Bhrigu. So comes from very ancient times. But you know, it's also read in between the lines, because in Bhrigu Sutra, as far as the sun in the third house is concerned, it just deals mostly with brothers and courage, because the third house is related to the aspect of support or help. And the first help is obviously yourself, which means your own courage. In olden times, the only help you most probably got was from your own brothers and sisters. So this became a very important aspect of the third house. But today, if you want to adapt ancient astrology to modern times, then you'll have to also say that the sun in the third house has got a lot to do with the other aspects of the third house. And I've done a video on what each house means. So whenever you find time, please watch that video. But to just give you a glimpse of what the third house means, it is basically mental inclination, memory, intellect, inclination to study, courage. Courage is the most important aspect of the third house. Then younger brothers or sisters, but in most cases you can read this as though it generally means brothers and sisters and not just the younger brothers. Cousins, neighbors, all these people tend to help you when you're in trouble. Short travel, communications. When you're in trouble, you always contact people. You call over phone and ask for help. So writing, change of residence, signing contracts or agreements, carrying tails. As far as the body is concerned, it deals with hands, throat, shoulder blade, collarbone, arms, and the nervous system. It is important to keep an eye on these matters that are concerning the third house. If the sun is in the third house, the native will be brotherless. If the sun is in the third house, the person would be extremely intelligent, buddhiman, anuja rahita, meaning Anuja means younger brothers, or may include younger sisters. And Jeshtanashaha, meaning his elder brothers will not survive. He doesn't say that you will not have an elder brother, but for some reason the person may not survive. This is what has been written, but again you can modify this to say that your younger brother may not be in good terms with you. In the 4th, 5th, 8th and the 12th year, he will suffer from bodily troubles. Here we see a rule written without considering the planetary periods that you're going through when you're 4 years old or 5 years old or 8 or 12. Sometimes in Bhrigu Sutra you find lines like this. So, but I always found that if the sun is in the third house and if trouble does happen, which is also indicated by the planetary period, then there is great trouble as far as the physical body is concerned. If the sun is associated with the malefic, the native will do cruel deeds. So if you had a situation like this with Saturn along, or maybe Rahu, which could make things worse because Rahu and Ketu always cause the eclipse if they're close to the sun. So if the sun is associated with the malefic, the person would do cruel deeds, possibly based on his courage to do cruel things. So you will see that in most cases, there is the other side of the coin. So when you're talking about courage, you should also look at other possibilities. A person can do cruel things, may become a thief. In this situation, you will find that Rahu is afflicting the sun, and where sun is already in a bad mood, and so this person can do cruel deeds. He will have two mothers and be valorous. Obviously, a person cannot have two mothers, so it means that he is taken care by another woman who will act as the second mother. He will be a brave fighter. He will have a good reputation and enjoy his wealth. When you read good combinations like this, it is applicable when, for example, when the sun is in a good mood like this. Or let's remove Rahu out of the... It can be possibly even like this, where the sun is in the house of Jupiter. When you're reading Bhrigu Sutra, it is important to keep in mind that you will have to look at the status of the sun. And if you have found that it is beneficially placed, then ignore all the negative statements that are being made with regard to the sun in the third house. If the sun is associated with the benefic, the brothers will become prosperous. So here something opposite has been declared. So let's introduce Jupiter. Jupiter can be here or maybe here. Whatever negative we have said about the sun being in the third house will not happen if Jupiter or another benefic is sitting along with the sun. If the lord of the third house is strong, the brother will be long-lived. So this is the case of the third lord being exalted, maybe in own house. Better than this is this house, because this is the Mulatrikona of Jupiter. If the sun is associated with the malefic and is also aspected by a malefic, the family will be destroyed. In short, the help from family would not be available at all. Instead of Jupiter, if you have Saturn over here, then it could become very bad. If the sun is aspected by a benefic and has no malefic influence, there will be growth of family, and the native will be wealthy, will enjoy good life and will be happy. So you find that Sage Bhrigu keeps talking about wealth, valor or courage, and then talks about support from brothers and sisters, and generally talks about family also. Brihat Jataka says that the person will possess a good intellect and great strength. Faladipika says the person will be full of strength, valorous, wealthy, generous, but he will be inimical towards his relations. Saravali, the native will be valorous, full of strength, respected, good-looking, learned and conqueror of enemies. Chamatkar Chintamani, the native will be full of valor. He will suffer on account of his real brothers. He goes on pilgrimage and always conquers his enemies in the battlefield. He is provided with comforts by the king. These are all new points, but let's take the common ones. And it's very obvious that the sun in the third does indicate a lot of good things. I've come to the end of this video, and I hope you have gained something from this. Let me know of your views, comments, and whenever I find the time, I'll answer your questions. Thank you so much for watching this video.